Barakatayahawa, Barakatayahawa Shai. Call halal lie, Yahawa Bashim Yahawa Shai. That's Hebrew. Interpret, bless Yahawa Shai. All praises to the Father Yahawa in the name of the Son, Yahawa Shai. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the Lord's hopeful elect scattered abroad, teaching his word in sincerity and truth. Shalom. All right, the title of this video is going to be Esau. All right, but brothers say E, you know, because Esau is clamping down on videos speaking about Esau because he's hiding the fact that, you know, that he is the Esau Edomites that the Bible speaks of, all right, which is the so-called white man. But the entitlement would be Esau thinks his future is his, thinks his technology is his future, you know, or somewhere around the lines, you know. When I load a video up, I think of a better way to phrase the title. But Esau believes that his technology is his future. And that just shows you how much of a carnal man he is. And technology is also considered witchcraft, you know. You know, their technology, you know, real technology, you know, would be the things that are natural to the earth, okay? And which the Lord is going to give us, starting with the hopeful elect, you know, real technology, if I should say, or, you know, the natural way of doing things, you know, the way the Lord designed this earth and us to be in it, you know, he would give us natural superpowers or spiritual powers, I should say. So I'll play a little bit, and I just want to get a video because you Edomites, you really think that all this technology that comes out is really your future, you know, and really it's your demise. All right, the scriptures tell you that Psalms 10, he will take him in the devices that he have imagined. All right, and you imagine your technology to be your future, but in our reality, it is your demise and your own downfall. You know, they're building AI intelligent robots, you know, machines. They're putting microchips, which is the mark of the beast, inside of people. They got so many high tech gadgets that they are doing. Things that can help you sleep, you know, things that can help you be smarter, whatever it is. You know, Esau is trying to modify his body, you know, into a machine, you know, to work as a computer, you know, because he doesn't have the spirit. The Lord is not dealing with him. Matter of fact, what's that? Romans 9 and 13, the Lord said, I have loved Jacob, but I have hated Esau. All right, this is not the kingdom, and nor is Esau going to bring a kingdom, a new kingdom, a heavenly kingdom. All right, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai is going to give us his elect, starting with his elect, the Israelites, who he have chosen, the kingdom. And you're going to really see how it's supposed to go down, you know, how we supposed to live in righteousness. Does not the scripture say in Psalms 29 and 2, when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn? When the righteous bear rule, the people rejoice? Well, the whole world is mourning because Esau is ruling the world. Okay? So, play a little bit of this.
I'm
You know, I don't know why they blotted out the people talking about their technology, but you know, you see, you know, visual of what they're doing. You know, having these summits, these meetings with bio, you know, like the title says, meet the biohackers seeking to turbocharge their bodies and mind. All right, this is the Esau's mindset, man. This is his way of advancing as a human, you know, and it's the wrong way. You know, it's not right. You know, this technology is witchcraft, man. You know, it's either for them to monitor you, to track you, you know, to have power over you. You know, the Most High didn't create machines. He created what? People. And he created what? Nations. All right. So, you know, even with that being said, because you got a lot of people, even some jakes out here that really are into that shit. Now, this is Job chapter 20:18. It says, that which he labored for shall he restore, and shall not swallow it down. According to his substance shall the restitution be, and he shall not rejoice therein, because he have oppressed and have forsaken the poor, because he have violently taken away an house which is built, which he builded not. And that's these Edomites. You're not gonna go quietly into this new world of yours with technology, you know, and microchips, you know, like, you know, you're gotten away with what you've done in the past. You know, it's just a matter of time that the Lord is going to judge you, you white people, straight up, you so-called white people, all right, you Edomites. This, it says, because he hath oppressed and hath forsaken the poor, because he hath violently taken away an house which he buildeth not. And that's ultimately this place which you call America. You know, we all know that this place was the Native and the Seminole Indians were here, so-called, which is Gad and Reuben. They were here, you know, before you, you know. And we also coming up, this is the month of November. I believe today is the 3rd and or the 4th, one of them. But we headed into what they call Thanksgiving. All right, so anyway, verse 20, it says, surely he shall not feel quietness in his belly. He shall not save of that which he desired. And he desired to, you know, modify this place, what you call North America, and the people here, and turn this into a new world. You know, he's establishing a new world government, a one world currency, all right, in which they call New World Order. But the Lord said, surely he shall not feel quietness. You're not going to be, it's not going to be, you know, no pressure. No, you're going to feel pressure because you're going to stand upon your feet. All right. It says, in his belly, he shall not save that which he desire. There shall none of his meat be left there. Therefore shall no man look for his goods. In the fullness of his sufficiency, he shall be in straits. Every hand of the wicked shall come upon him. Okay, and that, and I mean, when it says the wicked, it's just talking about the other nations. Okay, it's talking about the men taking this Edomites down. All right, you know, hey, even the Israelites, you know, taking them down. It says, when he is about to fill his belly, he shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him, and shall rain it upon him while he is eating. Exactly. So when these Edomites think they're being successful in their new world order, surely do they know that the Lord is allowing them to eat so that he can destroy them. It says when he is about to fill his belly, when he's what, fulfilling his new world order, the Most High shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him and shall rain it upon him while he is eating. All right, because the Lord said he comes as a thief in the night, you know, which is like a surprise attack. Because here it is, you think that you in good case, but then the Lord surprised you, all right, with his son returning with the mighty angels, man, you know, taking away what you stole, you know, from others. So it says, verse 24, he shall flee from the iron weapon, and the bull of steel shall strike him through. It is drawn and cometh out of the body, yea, the glittery sword cometh out of the gall. Terrors are upon him. And that's talking about those nuclear missiles. Because the elites, ultimately, they're going to escape these nuclear missiles. All right? but they're going to be the first ones to go into slavery. It says, he shall flee from the iron weapon, and the bow of steel shall strike him through. It is drawn and cometh out of the body, like the, you know, the ICBM coming out of the silo. Yea, the glittery sword cometh out of the goal. All right. Terrors are upon him. All darkness shall be hid in his secret places. A fire not blown shall consume him. It shall go ill with him that is left in his tabernacle. The heaven shall reveal his iniquity, and the earth shall rise up against him. The increase of his house shall depart, and his goods shall flow away in the day of his wrath. This is the portion of a wicked man from the Most High, and the inheritance appointed unto him by the Most High. All right, so that is, you know, your future for Esau. Not this technology, and we're merging with machines and AI intelligence, and we all microchipped, and the elites are, you know, sitting in God's seat, you know, want to be a, they got this God complex where we're all worshiping them. And, you know, it's just same, it's the same exact thing when you watch these TV shows and movies, man. All right. You know, that is the idea of these Edomites. And before I leave out, let me get Job 5. This is Job chapter 5. Verse 11, it says, to set up on high those that be low, that those which mourn may be exalted to safety. He disappointeth the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. He taketh the wise in their own craftiness, and the counsel of the forward is carried headlong. All right, they meet in darkness in the daytime, and grope in the noonday as in the night. All right, but the point is in 12, it says, he disappointeth the devices of the crafty. Who is the crafty? Esau. So that their hands cannot perform their enterprise, their agenda. Okay? So I hope this lesson was edifying. It's quick, to the point. I want to give all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, Bahashim Rakakwadash. I'm going to give double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutations to all the Lord's hopeful elect. Shalom.